Next, you can see we are going to understand how to save electrical energy, because many of us doesn't know how to minimize the consumption of electrical energy. As you can see, almost across the globe, because of different change in environment conditions, because of global warming, I can say there is a much difference in change in environment. Okay, even in summer season, you can see we are getting rain. Even in winter season, you can see the temperature is almost more than 30 degrees centigrade. So why this is happening? Because of change in environment condition. So why there is a change in environment condition? Because of burning of fossil fuels, in short, I can say. So to save the environment, we have to minimize the consumption of electrical energy. So the first major thing to minimize the consumption of electrical energy is to use the renewable energy sources like solar, or you can talk about wind, or combination of solar or wind, or we have different sources also for renewable energy sources. But as per the LEED examination, LEED is actually a standard, okay, or an examination you can say, which is actually opted by architects to save environment. So from that certification or from that standard, I have taken few points, because being from electrical department, you have to be very, very efficient how to minimize the consumption of electrical energy. So here roughly I'm going to explain about the complete topic. Whenever you're going to work with any project, or in your home also, you can see that we are having numerous number of electrical and electronic equipments, TV, refrigerator, washing machine, MP3 player, music system, computers, laptops, and more than this only. But no one is not going beyond the limit of this. Everyone are crossing the limit. So usage of these equipments is not restricted. We can use, but we should have proper knowledge to use all these appliances. Because of improper knowledge or lack of knowledge, I can say, we are paying more electricity bill, which we are not actually using or consuming it. So we should know how to use a music system in a proper way so as to minimize the power consumption. We should know how to use a washing machine. For example, okay, if in your home you're having a washing machine, and even for small load, like small clothes, if you're going with a high load operation, so what happens? The power consumption will increase. That is waste of electrical energy. So here paying electricity bill is not conditioned. If you have money, you will pay the electricity bill. But okay, saving electrical energy and saving the environment is a major concern over here. So we should be very, very efficient to save the electrical energy. So here you can see, according to the electrical energy auditors. So who are the auditors? Nothing but the people who are going to make the tariff, or the people who are going to make the research and development in the electrical energy. So these people have said that almost like 5 to 10% of energy consumption we can minimize by changing our behavior itself. Like whenever you're going to leave the room, turn off your lights. Whenever you're not using your devices, better to keep into the sleep mode, or at least go into the standby mode. So this is a main thing because of which we are paying some 10% of extra electrical energy. So by means of saving electrical energy, which will directly refer to saving money. So at last, I can say, when you're going to save electrical energy, we are saving the money also. So the major appliances which we are using in home, what are the heavy load devices which we have in home? Like we have refrigerators, which we are going to use 24/7. Never we are going to turn off the refrigerators. Cloth washers, you can say, or your washing machine, dishwasher, as well as water heater also. These are heavy load devices in our home. And these are the equipments which will account for a big chunk of your monthly utility bill. Almost like 60% of your electricity bill will be because of these loads only. And if your refrigerator or washing machine, not only this thing, all your electronic devices, if they are a decade old, if it is of 10 years old, you are spending a lot more on energy than you need to. That means because of not certified from BEE, these equipments will consume more amount of electrical energy. Equipments which were made in 1990s or in 2005 also, till this age, these equipments will consume some more amount of electrical energy, because those are not configured into electronic way. So today's major appliances don't hog energy, means those equipments will never consume energy, electric energy, the way older models do, because they must meet minimum federal energy efficiency standard. Whenever you're going to launch any device into the market, like a washing machine or refrigerator, it will be tested and commissioned. So based upon that only, you'll be getting the approval, okay, to sell your product in the market. So these standards have been tightened over the years. Nowadays, it is very, very tight to launch any new product into the market, okay, because they have to meet the federal energy efficiency standards. Okay, so as per the LEED standard, it is recommended if you're using any kind of outdated electrical or electronic appliances, better to replace that. Go with a good manufacturing company. When you're going with good manufacturing company, what happens? The initial investment may be more, but on a long run, it will give you a good benefit. So never use any electrical or electronic model which is almost having a make more than 10 years old. Now we are going to discuss about different points. Okay, which point will consume how much amount of energy and how we are going to use that point. First, we are talking about lighting point. Lighting means number of lamps. Whenever you're going to use a lighting fixture. So get into habit of turning off lights. This is a simple habit we have to change, because by default, when you're going to turn off the lights, when you're going to leave the room, automatically you're going to save 0.5% of electrical energy. Next point states that use task light. What is task light? We're going to discuss in the future classes. So task light means the light which focuses on one specific area. Like you can see in my classroom, I'm having some 6 ceiling mounted lights. And in order to deliver a class, I need some illumination or brightness with some minimum amount of lux, like 250. So I have to switch on all my 6 lights in order to get a lux of 250. So to overcome the operation of these 6 lights, I can also place a light on a table which focuses only on my specific work plane area, so that I'm going to minimize the consumption of 5 electrical lights. So always go with a task light, the light which focuses on one specific area where you are sitting or where is your work plane. Okay, so that you're going to consume almost like 60 to 70% of your energy, and take advantage of daylight also. So this is the scope of an architect, to provide natural illumination in a very well mannered. If you're having a daylight in your room, so there is no requirement of artificial light in your room. So D does the lighting fixture also, almost for every 2 months or 3 months, better to go for the maintenance. Because of soil formation or dust particles, the illumination may get down. So that will also consume some more amount of electrical energy. Because of no illumination, what we're going to do, we're going to install a few more lights, but you're not going to de-dust the lighting fixture. So these are the points which we have to use whenever we're talking about the lighting fixtures. Now in lighting, which type of light is suitable and which type of light will consume, okay, the electricity in much aspect. So first we have the CFL. About the configuration of CFL, we are going to discuss later. I hope everyone knows the CFL, the compact fluorescent lamp, the tube I can say. So this will consume less energy when compared to your normal lamps. Okay, normal bulb is what? Nothing but your incandescent lamp. When compared to incandescent, it will minimize the consumption almost like for 75%. 4 times we are getting a difference between the normal incandescent lamp. And the life of this CFL is also more when compared to your incandescent lamp. And in this, we are having the electronic chokes. In the olden days, we used to find the electrical chokes. Even if you go with local manufacturing companies, there you can see the choke will not be of good tested and commissioned area. So that will consume some more amount of electricity. So always try to select an electrical choke or a ballast which is using the medium as copper. Because when you're going to use a copper, so it will minimize the consumption for almost like 2%. And whatever type of light you're going to use, it can be incandescent, it can be CFL, it can be FL, it can be LED. Always you have to turn off the lights when you're going to leave the room. And you can see, use energy saving light bulbs. Even on the lighting fixtures, you can see you'll be finding the star labels like 3-star, 4-star, 5-star. So as you're going to increase the star value, okay, like if you're opting for 5-star, so what happens? Okay, the cost will be more. The cost will be more, but on long run, it will give you a good benefit. And you can see here, a single 20 to 25 watts energy saving bulb. Okay, that means if you're going with a good manufacturing of 25 watts of bulb, on an average, it will give you the difference of 100 watts ordinary bulb. Instead of using the 100 watt ordinary bulb, you can go with 25 watts of good quality bulb. But many of them will do, okay, they will go with local manufacturing company to minimize the cost. But that light will not give the enough amount of lumen to achieve your lux value. So try to go with good manufacturing companies only. I hope it's very clear till now. Next, you can see save on your fridge and freezer or refrigerator, you can save. So avoid putting warm or hot food into the fridge or freezer. Okay, so whenever you're going to keep anything into your refrigerator, bring down that utensil or your container into the room temperature value. Once it reaches to your room temperature, then only keep that utensil into your refrigerator. And always try to clean your condenser coil minimum for every 6 months. And if you're going to use an old refrigerator, it is recommended to replace, because that will consume the double the amount of electrical energy for the same capacity. And whenever you're going to use a refrigerator, go with the same capacity. Never overload the refrigerator. You're going to overload the refrigerator, what happens? The thermostat will not turn off your compressor, because of which it will take the same amount of electrical energy. So never overcrowd or never overload your refrigerator. And if in your refrigerator, if you're getting the ice, so try to remove that ice, because in order to maintain that ice, the temperature of the fridge will be maintained, because of which, again, the compressor will consume the more amount of electrical energy. Again, you'll be getting some more amount of electricity bill. And this ice or will be because of improper door seals. So always try to close your door in a proper way. Or if the insulation of the door is not good, so try to replace the insulation of your door. And never keep your refrigerator into the kitchen area if it is very small. And next to your refrigerator, never keep any kind of hot appliances, your microwave oven, range oven, or your kitchen stove. Try to provide minimum 30 centimeters of clearance space across the fridge, the backside, right, left side. Minimum 30 centimeters of clearance you have to provide, so that maximum amount of ventilation is obtained. And never cross a temperature of 40 degrees Fahrenheit for your fridge, and for the freezer, 0 degrees Fahrenheit, because it is not required. And whenever you're going for a long vacation, always switch off your refrigerator and keep the door open, because whenever you're coming back, the fridge will be ready to use for you. Next, talking about water heater or your geyser. So in kitchen,
sir,
yes, Mr. Fahd.
Sir, what about inverter fridges? Nowadays, we are having in the market inverter fridge.
Whenever you talk about
how they save energy,
whenever you talk about any equipment, okay, which is certified from the BEE standard, by default, it will be the inverter-based model only. So when you talk about inverter-based model, it is using a pure sine wave equipments, and there is no requirement any kind of AVRs like automatic voltage regulators or voltage stabilizers. Following, the power consumption will be very minimum, even if you're going for any huge or heavy devices like your air conditioners, refrigerators, and even your air conditioned refrigerators. And one more, there's a device, your dispensers, water coolers for all these devices. These are using the inverter based technologies. Okay, but when you talk about the equipments which we used to use in 2005, 2002, during that period, don't find any kind of inverter-based technologies. Next, we talk about the water heaters, okay, or the water geysers also, you can say. So in domestic point of view, for the kitchen, for the utility area, or for your bathing point of view, never go with a temperature more than 140 degrees Fahrenheit, because it is not required. What many of us will do, we are going to heat the water more than the requirement. Again, we are going to dilute, okay, which is again the loss in electrical energy. Unwantedly, we are going to boil the water. Again, we are going to dilute the water. So insulate your hot water pipes also. Okay, go with any kind of nitrile rubber, or go with any kind of your CPVC tubes, okay, to maintain the temperature of the water. When you're going with any kind of plumbing design, there you can see we have two different types of pipe. One is hot and cold, and one is only cold. So always try to provide the water connections, your shower connections, especially for the hot and cold water tubes. These tubes or these pipes will maintain the temperature also, as well as these tubes will have the withstanding capacity to withstand till 200 to 300 degrees Fahrenheit also. And repair dripping hot water taps immediately. If there is any kind of leakage after using the taps for years and years, try to repair it, because we are using electrical energy to get the hot water. So we should not waste the hot water anytime. And whenever you're not using, try to close the tap, okay, in the full mode condition. Again, about washing machine, wash full loads of washing machine. You will use your machine less often. For a simple or a small pair of clothes, never go with washing machine. Try to provide with the full capacity and try to use the washing machine as per the requirements, okay? And don't go for high temperature rating configuration if there is no requirement. Okay, nowadays we can see in the washing machines, we are having to set the temperature of the water, temperature also. So especially for the baby clothes, we have that. But if you're not going to use the baby clothes, never go with the temperature option. And also go with, for the spin cycle if there is a requirement. Okay, and don't go for the tumble drying option. Tumble drying means what? Nothing but your dhobi pachad, I can say in Hindi. And if you need to go with tumble drying, try to go with lower temperature. Both the temperature value and this option, never try to set it one time because the power consumption will increase. Again, talking about oven or electrical cooker. So make sure your oven door closes tightly. If it is not closed, it will not get operated. In the olden days, we used to go with conventional ovens, but now we are going with microwave ovens. Okay, because the power consumption is very, very minimum in the microwave oven when compared to conventional oven. Like in a microwave, if you're going to use for 2 minutes, in the conventional, we have to go for the 5 minutes. And keep the center of the pan over the element. Okay, exactly at the center, I can say, because exactly in the cabin of your oven, when you see, the element will be at the center. So keep your utensil or your container exactly at the center so that maximum amount of temperature, okay, will be at the midpoint only. Only boil the amount of water that you need. Not only the water, whatever you're using in the oven, try to go with the same capacity. Never go for the higher operations or options and never again bring down from that option to the other option. Talk about the coffee maker or your tea. So go with the options as you require. Don't go for all the options. When you talk about computers or laptops or desktop, it is recommended to go with all-in-one desktop nowadays because the power consumption is very less, or you can go with laptops also. Because when you talk about a computer, a separate cabinet will be there, a separate monitor will be there, again, speakers will be separate. So all these things will consume different electrical energy. So by default, we are going to save electrical energy of 5% if we are going to use a laptop or all-in-one desktop. If we are going to use a desktop, because if you want to work in a very rough and tough way, so we go with desktops only. So if you're going with desktop, go with LED screens. Don't go for any kind of LCD or any kind of outdated CRT tubes. And when you're not going to use your laptop, try to keep it in the sleep mode, because approximately 40% of energy we are going to save. Like your computer is consuming some 200 watts. So almost like 40% you're going to save. Because when you're not going to use your CPU or when you're not going to use your computer, when it is in the sleep mode, try to switch off your monitor also, because monitor will only consume half amount of electrical energy. So try to switch off your monitor. And we think that providing a screensaver will save the electrical energy, but it is false. Screensaver will save your computer screen energy, but not your electrical energy. And when you're going to use desktop, try to provide different on-off switches. So as per your requirements, you can turn on and you can turn off. When you talk about laser prints, so it will consume some more amount of electricity when compared to your inkjet printers, but quality of laser print is very good and the speed is also very more over here. Again, talking about ceiling fan. Okay, normal ceiling fan of almost like 300 mm sweep value. So this will consume almost like 20 units of electrical energy, almost approximately on an average in a month, 22 units of electrical energy. Okay, and many of them will think that if you are going to increase the fan speed, the power consumption will increase, but it is false. But generally what happens is when you're going to decrease the speed more than the limit, when you're going to increase the speed more than the requirement, like what many of them will do, they are going to place one more capacitor. They are going to attach one more capacitor to increase the speed. It is not recommended, because the amount of power consumption will increase. If there is a requirement of speed, try to install one more fan, but never go with all these options. And if you're not going to use the fan with the rated speed, like if your fan is having a speed of 1500, but the requirement is something like 2000. So what happens? There will be the generation of heat energy, because of which, again, the power consumption will increase. And when you talk about regulators or dimmers, try to go with electronic regulators only. Don't go for the electrical choke type of regulators. So at last, I can conclude that whatever device you are going to select or whatever device you are going to design, try to go with a good manufacturing company. I agree that the initial investment will be more, okay, but on the long run, it will be much efficient for you, much efficient for you. And in many countries, efficiency rating labels are mandatory. Even nowadays on the transformer also, you can see you're getting the star label. Like if you go with good manufacturing companies like Toshiba, Bell, ABB, these are the manufacturing companies which are giving you the star label for the devices also, even for the transformer. And this label will provide you the annual consumption of electricity information. I hope regarding this topic, it's very clear.